Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In construction, projects are usually broken down into work lots, which are smaller, more manageable sections of works. So if you have, for example, 1 kilometre of roadworks, it might be broken down into 10 100 metre lots. And each lot is going to contain a verification checklist, an ITP for each type of works, for example, earthworks, concrete, drainage, and so on. In this video, we're going to look at how you can manage your lots inside of Dashpivot, which is much more organized and efficient than the manual work required of paper and legacy systems. So I've gone ahead and set up a lot management register template inside of Dashpivot. I'm going to go ahead and create a lot now by clicking this green button here. You see that the form has already been set up, so we might just add some details in the text field, you know, maybe the lot ID is 1, 2, 3, 4. We can give it a description. Maybe that's a chainage reference. It might be, you know, chainage 100 to chainage 250, for example. Date assigned, we can just plug that in, and so on. You can fill out this form, which is basically all of the items of information which are associated with this particular lot. We've got some category fields which we can go ahead and check off as an example. Date of lots closed. Some of these fields will get filled out later on. For the purposes of this, you know, we're just creating the lot to begin with. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. And you'll see that we've got that lot now stored inside of Dashpivot. Now over time, what you'll end up with is something that looks a little bit more like this. So you're going to have multiple lots set up inside of Dashpivot. What's really handy in Dashpivot is that you can convert all of this information into a register, which is something a little more similar to something like Excel. And you'll see here, you know, we've based on the fields inside of the template, we can organize all of these columns inside of the register by clicking this Edit Columns button here, and we can rearrange any of these columns, if you will, and we can turn them on and off, for example. I'm happy with the way that it's set up at the moment, and you can see that it works like a register where, you know, we can then filter, for example, by all of the lots that are open or closed. Apply that filter and it will show me all of the lots which are open as an example. A couple of things on this. If we want to export all of these lots out, if we want to push it into something like Excel, we can just make a selection and you'll see that the options appear at the top of the screen. So we can export it as a CSV file if we want to open it up in Excel, or we can export this register as a PDF. And if we want to download all of the individual forms, so each of these lots onto a company branded PDF, we can select download forms. So that pretty much wraps up this video. If you want to get started with a lot template, you can access one for free via our free public template library inside of the templates section. If you go to templates and click add new template, you can go to choose from free public template library. Just search for lots and there'll be a couple of templates there. And that's really how you can organize your lots with Dashpivot.